Hello and welcome to another Mindbreeze tutorial. Today we will look at an introduction to app telemetry with examples of analyzing search, analyzing crawling, how to export the logs, as well as general reporting tools including reports, charts, service checks, and user feedback. Let's start with the example of analyzing search queries. Please note, for this example, we are using a web connector which has indexed stocksnap.io. For more information, please see our video about setting up a web connector. First, let's log into the Management Center. In the search client, after searching for tree, you can see that we have results from stocksnap.io. Now, in a second tab, let's open up AppTelemetry. We can access this in the Management Center via Reporting, Telemetry Details, and pop this out in a new tab. When we select Applications on the left, we can see links to all of the log pools available to us. On the right, in the Mindbreeze section, we can see all logs for the search pipeline, from crawling to searching. As we want to analyze the search and the queries, let's start by looking at the client service log pool. When we open this log pool, we see a new page with new options. For now, we are only interested in View Telemetry Data, which will show us the logs directly. The logs from the search client will show all events which happen client-side, such as queries, search suggestions, previews, and more. Now we're looking at the logs directly, let's sort by time and look at the columns in more detail. The duration tells us how long this event took in the client service. For example, this search event took 173 milliseconds to process. The method column tells us which type of event took place. Search. This is a real query which can be triggered by the search box or with the API. Suggest. This is a typical search suggestion, including recent queries, similar searches, or suggestions from CSV. Search in constraints. This is logging the selection of special filters in special data sources, for example, Exchange. This is not logged for every data source. Preview. This is if a customer clicks on preview to see the preview of a result, and the content will be loaded. The servlet column shows us which client service API is handling the processing. The query column tells us which query was triggered by the end user. Count is the number of requests used by the client service to fulfill the search request. Results shows us the amount of results shown to the end user by this client specifically. Total count shows us the total number of results returned. No results is a Boolean column which displays whether no results could be found for this query. The status column shows us the HTTP status code returned by the client service. The user column will show the name of the user who triggered the search. This user is provided by the configured SSO method, for example, Kerberos or SAML. If we want, we can easily narrow down the result set by adding filters. We can do this by right-clicking any value of the column we want to filter on. Let's right-click the method column and add a new filter so we only see results where method equals search. We can see that each query has two rows in the logs, one for triggering the search with zero results and one for returning the search results. Now let's look at a row with results returned in more detail. We can do this by selecting the row and looking at the details pane on the bottom half of the screen. If we have a look at the associated requests in here, we can see that all services involved in delivering this result from the index to the client service. This is the pipeline on the left-hand side of the architecture diagram. This is very handy as we do not need to jump between log pools to follow the full process of one document. We can simply look at associated requests to find all relevant logs. Now let's have a look at all of the services involved in delivering this result to the front end. Firstly, the client logs. Duration shows us how long all operations on this service took to deliver the result. Service shows us exactly which service was used. This shows the direct web service path. The ports displayed are only reachable when accessed locally directly from the appliance. The agent shows us the user agent of the browser, which was used when the search was made. The No Results column is a Boolean column indicating whether results were found or not. The Status column shows us whether the execution of tasks on this service were successful or not. The client service logs we have already covered in depth previously. Now let's look at the query service. For every index, there is one dedicated query service. So in this case, we see four rows as four indexes were searched across when the query was made. The column duration shows us how long the requests took. The service column shows us which service the log is created from. The query column allows us to see the query which was sent to the query engine. Please note, if different query transformation services, such as the stemmer, synonym transformer, etc., are used, the query which is sent to the query engine may vary from query service to query service. They do not need to be identical. The servlet column allows us to see which servlet of the index was used to accomplish the task. Now let's take a look at analyzing user interaction. AppTelemetry records all user interactions, therefore it's easy to take a look at which filters were selected, which buttons were clicked, and what actions were taken. Let's open up AppTelemetry again and head to the client service query log pool and view telemetry data. Again, we can see some columns which we have seen before, such as duration and service, but we also have many new columns available to us. Action shows which action was triggered by the user's interaction. Operation shows which operation was performed. Referrer shows which UI was used. Referrer schema shows which protocol was used to access the search UI. Referrer host shows on which host the UIs are located. Query shows which query was executed. Query constraint shows which filters are selected to constrain the search. Now let's make a search and analyze our own usage. Let's load up the client service and search for tree. We will also activate some filters here. Let's set the date to August 2019. When we go back to the client service query logs and refresh, we can see the date we selected when hovering over the query expression. Now, let's take a look at analyzing crawling with the web connector as an example. Firstly, we'll head back to the start page of AppTelemetry and then open the crawler service and view telemetry details. Now we're looking at the crawling logs, let's sort them by time and add a new filter, so we're only seeing logs where the operation contains the term crawl document. Now we can see a list of all documents crawled by the crawlers. Let's take a closer look at one of these on the details pane below. As before, let's take a look at the associated requests and investigate exactly what services are used when this document is ingested by Mindbreeze. In our architecture diagram, we're now looking at the process on the right-hand side, from data source to index. This includes the crawler service, filter service, and others. Let's take a closer look at each of these. The filter service focuses per file type on extracting the content from the documents to be indexed, including performing additional actions such as PDF previews and OCR scanning. The content filter service is a part of the filter service itself. Here we can see the status, as well as extension, category, and category instance of the document to be indexed. The extension mesThumbnail URL is the thumbnail which was automatically generated by the filter. The index service will show us these documents as they enter the index. We can see the operation is marked as insert, as well as the key used for indexing. Note how both the thumbnail and the document were inserted. Finally, we can see all network requests which were made for the crawling and indexing process of this document. As we indexed a web page with the web crawler, quite a few network requests were made. We can see the scheme, host, and URLs which were used to make these requests. Now, let's take a look at how we can monitor a crawl run from AppTelemetry. Again, we will go to AppTelemetry and open the crawler service log pool. This time, instead of constraining to crawl document, we will instead constrain to crawl run. This will show us entries which encapsulate a full crawling run, rather than just one crawled document. Here, we can now see the status of all of our crawl runs. the status description, and more. If we click on one of these, we can see more details below in the Additional Details pane. We can see further information about the indexing process and the crawl run itself. Next, we will look at how we can export AppTelemetry logs so they can be worked with offline or sent to colleagues or Mindbreeze consultants. Again, let's head to the start page of AppTelemetry and open the crawler service and view telemetry data. We can select the rows we are interested in with the checkbox on the left-hand side, and then click Download. We can then select the download type we wish, and then save these entries to file. Now, let's take a look at how we can use AppTelemetry to create reports. We'll navigate to the AppTelemetry start page, and then open the client service log pool. After this, we will open View Request Statistics. We can choose the dimension we want to use to generate the report. In this case, we will select Status to see a quick report of the status of all client logs. We can also constrain to a specific date or specific time ranges as we require. If we want to view all of the success documents in more detail, we can simply double-click this in the report to gain a more detailed view. As well as viewing reports, we can also use dashboards and charts to view the same data in a visual way. Let's first take a look at some of the standard Mindbreeze dashboards, which are included out of the box. The dashboard InSpire Server Health shows us the health of the hardware on the system, including CPU and hard drive usage. We can change the layout of the dashboard to suit our needs, and we can also interact dynamically with the charts to gain a more detailed view about certain data points. Index Statistics shows us a detailed view of indexing operations by action and by category, as well as a total number of items indexed. This can be used to analyze which items may be causing load on the system. The Performance dashboard shows us the front-end performance. With this, we can analyze the performance of the appliance and load balance services if required. We are also able to view and analyze end-to-end response times, which will show if the connection between user and appliance is a problem. As well as this, we can also see further charts detailing response times and availability. The Search Experience dashboard is one of the best ways to analyze usage of the client service and user search. We are able to see multiple aspects of the ways users use and experience searching and viewing results. We can see the number of searches per time interval to identify usage patterns, as well as seeing the number of different users and searches without results. We can also see top 10s for search terms and for searches without results. This can help identify areas where, for example, synonyms would be required to increase the user search experience. We can also see the top 10 web browsers used. This can be used to ensure front-end search apps are quality assured for these browsers. All of the charts which you can see with these dashboards are simple HTML and therefore can be embedded anywhere it's required, and it's even possible to create your own charts for custom data views. Now, let's take a look at another aspect of monitoring available within AppTelemetry. With Mindbreeze service checks, it is possible to monitor the entire infrastructure associated with your Mindbreeze appliances. The monitoring for the appliance itself is automatically set up out of the box. To see service checks, first open up AppTelemetry and then navigate to the status pane on the left-hand side. We can see several different sections available to us. Let's go through these now. Agents shows us all of the running AppTelemetry agents available. Each Mindbreeze node has one agent associated with it. This is important for multi-appliance setups, such as producer-consumer, but it is not as important with a single appliance setup such as this one. Fabrisoft AppTelemetry shows us the health of the AppTelemetry service itself. AppTelemetry runs within its own sandbox, so its health does not depend on the health of the Mindbreeze services. The Mindbreeze server health shows us all of the out-of-the-box service checks for the Mindbreeze hardware and software components. For example, whether backups were successful, how much hard drive space has been used, and other system resource usage, and more. Mindbreeze Services shows us the availability of the different Mindbreeze services, such as client, filter, and index services. Further details include license usage and status. With app.telemetry, you also get an integrated ticket system included out of the box, available via the feedback button. Let's take a look at this on the search side now. In the search client, let's perform a search which returns no results. In this case, a user can provide feedback for this unsatisfactory result with the yellow feedback button on the right-hand side. With this button, users can leave textual feedback as well as categorize this type of feedback, as well as capturing an automatic screenshot which can be cropped and edited as the user sees fit to highlight the issue. The user can also black out parts of the search they do not wish to send. Now, let's send this and jump back to app.telemetry and see how it's transmitted. When we open the inbox on the left-hand side, we can see we have a new item in the inbox. When we open this, we can see all of the details given by this user, including the feedback text, the screenshot, and user metadata. Opening the screenshot allows the full-sized image to display. Once an admin is happy with this, they can mark the ticket as done so that the inbox is kept organized and clean and ready for new tickets. If necessary, tickets can also be deleted permanently. Of course, there is always more to learn. To expand on what you have seen today, you could also look into custom service checks to check the status of custom services or resources, automated email alerts, which can send alert mails to specified addresses when certain service check limits are reached, customized feedback dialog, and customized charts and dashboards with fully customizable data sources and data views.